Hi, I'm Mike Craig. I'm the R&D project manager for Keysight's IntegraVision family of power analyzers. Today I'm going to talk about using our wiring manager to configure both delta and Y three-phase measurements with our instrument. So to start off, I'm just going to go right over here and hit our wiring hard key. And what you're going to see, this is going to bring up our wiring diagram. So as you can see, in the default state of the instrument, each of the four input power channels on the PA2203A are set up to be for individual measurements, right? They're completely separate, they're not grouped together. So to start out, to group them, I'm just gonna go right down here to the channel selection key, and we're gonna start off with a three-wire, three-meter, three-phase configuration that you would typically use for measuring in a delta configuration. So what we can see, two things happened immediately here when I turned this group on, which is called group A. First, the options for channels 2 and 3 are grayed out because channels 1, 2, and 3 have been grouped together. And then the other thing is we notice this wiring diagram now has been completely updated to reflect the delta wiring configuration I've chosen. The key thing to notice here is that the actual connections of the instrument are along the bottom of the screen, so I have channels 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the rear panel of the instrument. And so basically the diagram showing how do I connect up to my voltage and how do I connect up to the current inputs. And one thing we can see is if we actually change the state of the current input from the internal shunt path to the external transducer input, we can see the wiring diagram automatically updates to reflect that. So that's the 3 meter delta mode. I'm gonna quickly highlight here, I'm gonna switch to the 2 meter three wire mode. And what's crucial about this particular configuration is it can allow the user to access applications where you typically think that you need a 5 or 6 channel power analyzer, because you can do the three phase measurement with 2 meters. So for example, I have channels 1 and 2 set up for that 3-phase 2 meter measurement. I can go over here and configure channel 3 and 4, again, for a three-phase, three-wire, two-meter measurement. So in that way, for certain systems, I could actually characterize a three-phase in, three-phase out system. Another example would be a solar inverter with dual maximum power point tracking, where I could configure channels 1 and 2 sort of as DC inputs, and then have the channels 3 and 4 grouped together for a three-phase, two-meter measurement. The last configuration here that I'm going to show is the Y measurements, or the four-wire, three-meter configuration. So we can see, again, the diagram is updated. It's now set up for Y, and basically, again, you can look at the diagram as you make your connections to the instrument and proceed from there. So I'm just going to adjust the shutter here on the back of the instrument. And right now, so again, we have channels 1, 2, and 3 groups. So I'm going to go ahead and close the wiring diagram. I have some simulated data up here on the screen. And what we're actually looking at is the input to a three-phase rectifier right now. So one really nice feature when I have my channels grouped together is the autoscale function. So it typically behaves sort of like how you would think any Keysight scope would behave when you hit autoscale, except when you have a group channel, we have this extra auto scale option here, which you can select from the soft menu down here by going to arrange traces by group. It'll run another auto scale, and now what it's done is it's sort of grouped the voltage and the current traces from that group together. And the other important thing is it's also changed the vertical scaling on all three channels in that group to be the same, which allows you to kind of easily identify, is there any kind of miswiring or is there any kind of asymmetry on my three phases here? So you could easily see that just by inspection because they've all been scaled to the same range. So we'll take a quick look here. Now that I've got these group measurements, in the power quality analysis mode, I can now, if I go to my source selection here, I can now choose group A, which is again channels 1, 2, and 3. And I see over here on my power quality panel, I've got a new set of measurements reflecting that group. So I can see the individual voltage and current measurements of each phase, and I can also see average measurements for the group. And then similarly with real power and apparent power, I can see the powers of the individual phases as well as the group real power, the group apparent power, and then finally the group reactive power here at the bottom. And then of course we have power factor measurement and average power factor measurement here at the bottom, as well as voltage and current frequency measurements, which because of the nature of the rectifier I'm looking at, you can see the current frequency is actually measured to be twice that of the input voltage. Just to quickly highlight how group measurements are used in some other modes, you can see they also apply. So if I they also apply in the energy mode, I can select the that group as a source. We can also look at efficiency, where I think this is probably one of the most powerful uses of group channels, where I can, both as an input and an output if I wanted to, I can select my group channels. And then I think finally, another very important feature would again be our phasor diagram feature, where again I choose the source, I go to group A, it brings it up, we can see we sort of have the three phases, the currents are pretty close alignment here, but again all I have to do is select that group measurement and my phasor diagram is ready to go. So in summary, we saw how to use the wiring diagram to set up both delta and Y group measurements, and then some of the analysis features that we can easily use once we have those group measurements set up. Thanks a lot.